Good evening, everyone. My name is Vandika Lamba. I am a co-founder of Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. Today, I am here to talk about the effects of COVID on aviation industry. The COVID-19 has had a significant impact on the aviation industry due to the travel restrictions and a slump in demand among the travelers. The COVID-19 has spread worldwide without acknowledging the borders. It has impacted all the industries, all sectors, all aspects of our lives, with decreasing economy and financial losses. Significant reduction in passenger numbers have resulted in flights being cancelled or the aircraft flying empty between the airports, which was a big loss for all the airline industry. The change in the behavior of the passengers following the COVID-19 crisis, travel restrictions, and the ensuing economy crisis have resulted in a dramatic drop in demand for the airline services. According to IATA, the passenger air transport service has been dropped down to 90% in April 2020. Yes, that's a shocking figure. Up to a drop down of up to 90% in April 2020. And it is still down with 75% in August 2020. Let's talk about the uncertainties which the aviation industry has faced. First and the foremost point, which everyone of us be aware of, that is unemployment. Most of the airline companies have asked their workers and the airline staff to leave the job. Or maybe they can be a part of the airline, but they won't be able to pay the salaries. This is not only with the aviation industry, but the whole world was suffering because of COVID-19 virus. The second big loss for the airlines was whether it was 75% boom in the aviation industry during the COVID-19 crisis. The government, the Ministry of Health, has advised all the airports to keep the safety and health requirements at the airport. So basically, all the airports, they have to undergo all the safety measures to be present at the airport. You must be aware of PPE kits, the temperature checking machines. So the cost involved in the health and the safety related measures, it has also increased the revenue of the airline. Third is your social distancing measures. The health ministry, they have informed the airline to keep the air traffic up to 50% only when this COVID-19 started. It is now up to 75%, and we hope for the best. Like if we have a vaccination soon in our country, we can go for 100% occupancy in January 2021. Let me show you some screens which will help you to understand better. So this is known as COVIDification of the aviation industry. Myself, I told you, Vandika Lamba, I'm a co-founder of Aircruise Aviation Private Limited. My details are there in front of your screens. You are very much welcome to get in touch with us for more information. The air transport industry worldwide is on life support due to the COVID-19 because of the losses of the job, unemployment, and many other factors. Global aviation industry is concerned with the manufacturing and operations of all types of aircraft and related services during the transportation, like passenger airlines, cargo, aircraft, airport, and catering. So you can say each and every department of the aviation industry has been affected with the COVID-19. Due to the effect of COVID-19, there was a tremendous decline in the tours and travels as a large number of international as well as domestic flights. Well, I have been working at the airport from the last 15 years and I have never seen ever in my life the airports being so vacant. The duty-free shops are vacant, the restaurants at the food lounges are vacant. in my this is like a history to me, you know, it never happened. So effect of the COVID-19 of the aviation industry, it can be observed, including, as I said, the whole part of the world, North America, Europe, and everywhere in the world. The key companies of the aviation industry that are getting affected globally are Qatar, China Eastern, Lufthansa, and our domestic and international airlines worldwide. So it is an estimate which indicates that the aviation industry will crash land this fiscal year with a revenue loss of 25,000 crores Indian rupees. As I told you, when this COVID started, the occupancy, the ministry has informed the airline to keep a consistency of the passenger transport to only up to 50%. Can you imagine an aircraft going empty? 50% the seats and 50% is empty. So this is even a one seat, even a single seat going empty. When we were used to work at the airport, so even a single seat going empty, that we call it as a loss to the airline. So when the ministry said 50%, so you can imagine the losses the aviation industry has suffered. Effects of COVID-19 in the various segments of aviation. Aviation industry can be divided into airline codes. That's the codes, American Airlines, British Airways, Delta, and American. Aircraft manufacturers, Airbus and Boeing. Aviation cargo, aviation MRO, aviation training, and allied aviation services. Significant reductions in passenger numbers have resulted in flights being cancelled or planes flying empty between the airports, which in turn massively reduced for the airlines and forced many airlines to lay off the employees. So this is the year, like you can say, starting March, every one of us may have faced the financial losses, or that, you know, that the importance of salaries which we used to get. So every one of us, I'm sure, would have get to understand the importance of the salary. But yes, the patience and our faith in our government. But yes, I have seen people going down and, you know, emotionally broke down. Even you can say there are people who have committed, you know, they have gone to the wrong path. They have committed suicides as well, because yes, you have to have financial support to run your family. So this COVID-19 has made a very serious impact on the aviation industry. But let me tell you, I have been in this industry from the last 15 years, and I have never seen such kind of industry which is so booming, which is so growing, and ever, you know, never stoppable, you can say. So I would like to welcome, and I would like to say all the best to all the students who are studying aviation courses online, because and in this pandemic, I have also learned that everyone is doing work from home. But one thing I have learned is education never goes off, right? So education is the only industry which is going online as well. Schools are closed, so the classes are going online. So, and we have so many online courses. So I would like to boost the morale of all the students who are studying aviation, because see, COVID-19 is temporary. In another following week or maybe a month, we have a vaccination. And this is the first time the world has faced such kind of disease, right? So this is temporary, but our aviation industry is growing and blooming. So I would like to say all the best to all the students who are studying the aviation industries. And believe me, I, being an aviation professional, would always be promoting you. We have our aviation courses as well, with the Asiatic International Aviation Courses. So anyone, if you would like to join those courses, my numbers are there. You can be in contact with us. I'll share my screen again so that you can take a screenshot of the number. And you are very much welcome to join our aviation online courses. Okay. Thank you so much.